Hi, I'm Margaret Martin at Milio Guide, and today I have a really important topic to share with you that relates to bone health, and that's hormones. So when I give my professional teaching to other healthcare professionals, I often will use the analogy of looking at what the picture is that you want within your clients. And so for listeners, what is it that the picture that you want to see yourself in your retirement years? You know, do you want to have a nice strong skeleton that's supporting you and allowing you to do all the activities and keeping your independence? Or do you want to have a frail skeleton that's crumbling underneath you and not allowing you to go out and enjoy life because you're fearful of falling and fearful of breaking? And so in that creation of that picture, then you need to look at, and so I'm using the phone here on the little tripod, but in that creation of that picture, there's three strong legs to the health of our bones. That's evident throughout our life in terms of how it impacts the bones. One of the legs, which isn't here, is genetics. We don't have any control over that. The legs that we do have more control over are, one, our nutrition. Two, exercise, how much loading, how much weight bearing, how much pull and push and of the muscles that are happening on the bone. When they pull on the bones, they're helping build the bone. When you load and impact, you know, through jumping, through stepping, through brisk walking, all of these things load bone and help build the bone. But the third leg that is our discussion today is hormones. And so with those three legs being strong, you get the image and the picture that you want to have, and those are the things that you have in control of your life. So when it comes to hormones, we know that hormones are so very important. We know this by studies that look at children in their age and develop in their growth and development. The years sitting around puberty, those 2 years are so very important, that their nutrition and their exercise is optimized, because all that influx of estrogen and testosterone in their life is helping to build bone. So much so that over a quarter of the bone that they're going to build in their entire life happens in those 2 years. And so we also know that when we start looking at studies, when they have the exact same exercise program that's issued to premenopausal women, women who have their estrogen flowing nicely, and postmenopausal women who are on a depletion of estrogen, they are never able to get as good results with the postmenopausal woman, because although they may be just working just as hard and the nutrition may be just as good, they don't have the hormones there to help support the growth of the bone. And so something to think about throughout all your stages of life is, where are your hormones at? And this is just the start of a series that I want to share with you on hormones and bone health. So thanks for tuning in. I'm Margaret from Milio Guide.